It's the Porter Wagoner Show, starring Porter Wagoner and the Wagonmasters with Speck Rhodes and Norma Jean, bringing you your favorite songs and stars of the Grand Ole Opry.
We're so glad to see you and wondering how you've been. Everybody's feeling fine, let the fun begin.
Oh, thank you so very much and welcome to the show. Why don't you just
come on in, sit right down, and make yourself at home.
If I had one wish I could go back to my old neighborhood where the good folks, they all love you as their own. Then I'd go to my neighbor's house, knock on the door, and they'd all sing out,
come on in and sit right down and make yourself at home.
I sing the praises long and loud, cause they're all my friends and I'm mighty proud of the little old town back home where I was born. If I'd go back to hear them say in the good old-fashioned friendly way,
come on in and sit right down and make yourself at home.
Now they don't lock the doors at night, cause they all know they're doing right, and the good Lord's bound to have them for his own. When I get to summons on the judgment day, I hope that I'll hear my Savior say,
come on in and sit right down and make yourself at home.
Well,
come on in and sit right down and make yourself at home.
Thank you. Thank you. And a great big welcome to our show today. We've got two guests on this program, and a couple of the finest in the business. Of course, Mel Tillis and Waylon Jennings. And right now, I want you to meet an old boy who hails from down in the fine state of Florida. One of the finest songwriters in country music. One of the finest singers, too. Here he is, Mel Tillis. Let's make him up.
How you doing, boy?
Fine, man. And we've been looking forward to having you with us a long, long time.
Well, I'm just happy that I could come up here.
Well, we are too, man. And now listen, most of us
going in overtime, I see. All
this is one of the greatest guys around, and all of us in the business and around Nashville know he has a little speech defect, and it doesn't bother you singing at all or you writing at all or anything. You're fine, man.
Thank you. Do us
a good song, will you?
All right.
Did you remember me long ago? In your guilty memory, my love you traded for the night world, where all your dreams met with tragedy. Now do you remember how I love you so? On my knees I cried and I begged you not to go. Now it's too late for us, lonely girl, and I'm sorry I ran into you. All the love you traded for the night world found happiness with somebody new. Now do you remember how I loved you so? On my knees I cried and I begged you not to go. Now it's too late for us, lonely girl, and I'm sorry I ran into you. All the love you traded for the night world
found happiness with somebody new.
That's fine. I want you to do a little bit of another one. This is a little newer song than that's that one right. There is. And I want to go stateside.
Stateside's the name of it.
Yeah. Oh, do a little bit of it, will you?
A lonely G.I. in Japan.
Okay.
Well, the Japanese moon is bright tonight. Tokyo is full of life. Busy people everywhere. But busy people just don't care. I want to go stateside. Oh, Lord. I want to go stateside.
Right here. Thank you. Mack and Buck and the Fireball Mail. Now here is one of the prettiest songs I believe that I've heard in many, many years. And a lovely little lady to sing it for you. Miss Norma Jean, come on out. Let's have a nice hand. I think this is your best record that you've ever made for RCA. Tell us about it, will you?
Okay, this is the brand new one. Last night, I was going through a closet when, on a rack with my dresses, I found the shirt he had worn when he held me in his arms for the very last time. The shirt I knew he'd never wear again. As I took it from the rack, all my dreams came racing back. The faint perfume of sweet love filled the night. I could see his face. My lips as then, and I almost felt his arms round me tight. A shirt that even the gods must envy, for its arms once encircled a dream that only heaven could bring. Inside this shirt had beat the most wonderful heart in the whole wide world, and forever each thread shall remind me of him. I turned down a rolled up sleeve, and I scarcely could believe when I looked and saw a strand of my own hair. It was clinging like a vine to the shirt he left behind, as if to let him that I still care. I walked to the windowsill, and my eyes began to fill, and I thought I heard the soft wind call his name. And the shirt across my arm grew strange, soft and warm, as if I'd reached and held it to a flame. And there I stood, hearing only the beat of my own aching heart, lost in the dreams that might have been, and the shirt seemed as sorrowful as I, and just as empty, body and soul.
beautiful performance, Norma Jean. That's just great, and thank you so much for doing it. It's called The Shirt. That's Norma's on RCA Victor Records. Here's a kind of an old one, boys. Let's tell them about Uncle Penn.
Late in the evening, about sundown, high on the hill and above the town, Uncle Penn, with a little money down the rain, you hear Uncle Penn. Come from far away, the dance all night till the break of day, when they call him with a holler, do-si-do, when your Uncle Penn was ready to go. Late in the evening, about sundown, high on the hill and above the town, Uncle Penn, played the fiddle on the hound with rain, you could hear it talk, you could hear it sing. Well, he played an old tune called Soldier's Joy, and the one they called Boston Boy, but the greatest of all was Jenny Lynn. To me, that's where fiddling began. Late in the evening, about sundown, how the hill and above the town. You could hear it talk, you could hear it sing. I'll never forget that mournful day when Uncle Penn was called away. They hung up his fiddle, they hung up his bow, they knew it was time for him to go. Late in the evening, about sundown, how the hill and above the town. Played the fiddle, Lordy, how it ring. You could hear it talk, you could hear it sing.
Woo! Thank you. We'll be right back. Watch this.
Oh, boy. Thank you. Is that the telephone? That must be.
Hello, Sadie. Yeah, that's the phone. Heidi. Heidi, sugar, you about ready to go at the rodeo tonight? Yeah, but there's going to be a crowd there. I've been downtown helping the Boy Scouts with the traffic today. Yeah, Julius and Tommy Westbrook. Out in front of the drugstore this afternoon, the big fat woman from the sideshow, she come walking down the street and they got a pair of scales out in the front of the drugstore, and these scales are busted. Yeah, but she didn't know it, so she, the big old fat woman, got up on the scales, you know, the way. She dropped a penny in the slot, and Julius was standing there watching her. When she dropped the penny in, that hand went up to 55 pounds and stopped. Yeah, Julius looked at her, looked around me, and said, "Great Scott, Uncle Specs, she's holler." Yeah, they had a big parade downtown today. Had cowboys and Indians and everything for the big rodeo. Yeah, they were coming down the street, and me and the boys were sitting there on the curb watching them. I kept noticing Julius watching this Indian woman with her little papoose strapped on her back. Yeah, they were marching down the street, and this woman had her little papoose strapped on her back, and about a half block down the street, but Julius was kept looking down that way, you know. Dickie looked around me and said, "Well, Uncle Specs, that's the first pistol packing mama I ever saw with a rear gunner." "Look, honey, get all dressed up. I'll be by and get you directly." Yeah, I got us some reserve seats on the bleachers. Okay, goodbye. So long, Sadie.
What would you do? What would you do if Jesus came to spend some time with you? If Jesus came to your house to spend a day or two, if he came unexpectedly, I wonder what you'd do. When you saw him coming, would you meet him at the door with arms outstretched in welcome to your heavenly visitor? Or would you need to change some things before you let him in, like burn some magazines and put the Bible where they'd been? Oh, I know you'd give your nicest room to such an honored guest, and all the food you would serve to him would be the very best. And you'd keep assuring him that you was glad to have him there, that serving him in your home was joy beyond compare. But what about your family conversation? Would it keep up its normal pace? Would you find it hard each meal to say a table grace? Would you be glad to have him stay forever on and on? Or would you sigh with great relief when finally he had gone? You know, it might be interesting to know the things you'd do,
if Jesus came in person to spend some time with you.
What would you do? What would you do if Jesus came to spend some time with you?
How do you do? Well, we're back again. And thank you for watching that good message and for patronizing the folks that sponsor our show. Now, it's a great pleasure for me to introduce this boy because he's one of the fastest rising stars in country music. Records for RCA Victor Records and one of the finest boys that I've met. His name is Waylon Jennings. Let's make him up. Waylon, congratulations, man, on some fine, fine records.
Thank you very much, Porter.
And you have a lot of wonderful things in store for you if you keep writing good songs and recording them like you have been, believe me.
Hope so.
I want you to do a fairly new one for the Waylon Jennings, and it's what is the title of it?
It's called Time to Bum Again.
It is, yes.
Woman, you get meaner every day. It's hard to see. Pack my things and I'll be on my way, 'cause it's time to bum again. This house gets smaller with every day, and the walls are closing in. I've said all there is to say, and it's time to bum again. The time has come to bum again. I'm gonna see all the places that I ain't been. Woman, you've stirred up the wild, wild wind, and it's time to bum. Visit my buddy out in Bakersfield. We soldiered together years back. Talk night and day till there's no more to say. Then I'll move on down the track. May come back in a year or two, and you may not desire me then. Well, I've said all there is to say, and it's time to bum. Time has come to bum again. I'm gonna see all the places that I've been. Woman, you've stirred up the wild, wild wind, and it's time to bum again. Woman, you've stirred up the wild, wild wind, and it's time to bum again.
Hey, man, that's fine. Very good.
Thank you very much.
I want you to do one as a favor of all the Wagon Masters and many, many of our viewers, I'm sure, too. Anita, you're dreaming. How about doing that?
Thank you.
Would you?
I will.
Anita, come closer, stop crying and listen. I guess it's too late now, but somehow I must make you see. What we thought was our world is only a dream world, and we just can't go on like this. Anita, you're dreaming of a world that can never exist. Anita, it's over, there's nothing that's left now to say. Anita, you're dreaming, and I know it's better. Anita, come closer and close your pretty blue eyes. I guess it's too late now, but somehow you must realize that each time you're with me, my conscience reminds me of someone who's waiting alone. Anita, you're dreaming, and when you awake, I'll be gone. Anita, it's over, there's nothing that's left now to say.
Many, many thanks to you.
Thank you very much.
Lots of good luck to you, man. And believe me, keep the good records coming out.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Remember the name Waylon Jennings. Isn't he great? Sang so fine. We want to get our other guest back out here, Mel Tillis. Come back out, Mel, just a second. You wrote and, of course, recorded so many wonderful songs. Do a little bit of one of them that they might remember.
I want to go home. I want to go home. Oh, Lord, I want to go home.
No, that's not quite enough. Of course, of another one, please.
Wine, pretty red wine, pretty red wine.
That's it. That's got it. Thank you, Mel. Come back and see us again, man. Neighbors, that's all of our time. Thanks to Waylon Jennings, Mel Tillis, Norma Jean, Speck, and all the Wagon Masters. Join us again next week at the same time, will you? Bye, everybody. Thank you.
This has been the Porter Wagoner Show, a half hour of good country music and fun, brought to you from the home of the Grand Ole Opry.